Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the best BMW N54 bolt-on performance upgrades and how to build a 450 to 500 wheel horsepower N54. Right off the bat, Jake and I own three N54s. Somehow we've skipped over the best N54 bolt-on upgrades, so we're covering that video now. We do have quite a few N54s around and quite a bit of content on the N54, including Jake's single turbo 135i build behind me and also my 335i, which is on upgraded twin turbos. And with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss those upgrades. Number one on the list, we have a tune for the BMW N54. This is really going to be the single best bang for your buck modification and really the best starting point for getting into modifications and upgrading your BMW N54 engine. So a tune alone can offer power gains of about 50 to 80 wheel horsepower. The exact number depends on what stage or what map tune you are opting for. Really the biggest way that these tunes add power gains is simply by increasing the boost pressure and the PSI. The stock turbos run about 8 to 9 PSI from the factory. A tune can turn that up pretty significantly, and depending on what map you run, again, you can see those power gains of anywhere from about 50 to 80 wheel horsepower with just a tune, no additional modifications. So very impressive power gains right there for a simple modification that's about $200 to $500. Another main benefit of tuning the N54 is it really helps maximize the performance and power gains from additional mods that we'll be discussing throughout the rest of this video. But ultimately, again, this is going to be the single best bang for your buck and really the best starting point if you're just getting into upgrading your BMW N54. So when it comes to tuning, there are two primary options, the JB4 piggyback tuner as well as MHD flash tunes. The JB4 used to be a lot more popular. It gets a little bit more hate nowadays. Jake and I do both run the JB4 on the single turbo 135i as well as my upgraded twin turbo 335i with great success, so we don't have any complaints about it, but a lot of people tend to agree nowadays sticking with a flash only tune is the better route, and we tend to agree with that to some extent. So there really isn't a wrong answer here. Check both of them out, see which one suits your needs and preferences. Either way, again, both MHD and JB4 are great tuning options for the N54. Moving on to the second best bolt-on upgrade for the N54, we have an intake, or also often referred to as dual cone intakes, or DCI for short. The intake on the N54 is really simple. The factory airbox has two outlets essentially, and so that's why they are dual cone intakes when you go to upgrade. They're incredibly cheap because all it is two very simple 4 to 6 inch long pipes, as well as then the dual filter. So ultimately an intake upgrade on the N54 are going to run about $85 to $100, incredibly cheap. In terms of performance gains and benefits, you can see power gains in the ballpark of about 3 to 10 wheel horsepower, depending on how much boost you're running and what other modifications you have on the vehicle. Additionally, intakes add some awesome turbo and induction sounds. They look great in the engine bay, and they do make future access and maintenance very simple. So if you ever need to access that area in the future, those intakes slide out very easily compared to the stock airbox. Ultimately, if you're just getting into modifying your N54, we highly recommend the dual cone intakes, and it's an excellent mod to combine with the tune as your first two upgrades for your N54. Moving into upgrade number three to build a 450 to 500 wheel horsepower N54, we have downpipe upgrades. Downpipes are going to offer power gains in the ballpark of roughly 15 to 25 wheel horsepower alongside faster turbo spool. They'll allow you to run higher peak boost, and downpipe upgrades also make the turbocharger and engine's job a lot easier. So it's just good in general for the overall health and safety of the engine and turbochargers with downpipe upgrades. Now, when it comes to downpipes, really the main thing that offers all of these benefits is reducing back pressure. So that leads us into a topic about Catless versus high flow catted downpipes. Catless downpipes will completely delete the catalytic converters, so they are going to offer the biggest benefits, the bigger power gains. However, Catless downpipes will have a tougher time passing any form of emissions or visual inspections. Even if you don't have to do an actual sniff test, if it's just a visual inspection, the mechanic will likely notice the lack of catalytic converters, and that could result in an instant fail. And again, if you have to do a sniff test or any actual emissions testing, then it will be tough to pass with the Catless downpipes. So that's really where high flow catted downpipes come into play. They don't reduce quite as much much back pressure since there are still catalytic converters in place. However, you shouldn't have any issue passing any form of sniff test, emissions testing, or visual inspection with the high flow catted downpipes. When it comes to specific power gains, I had mentioned about 15 to 25 wheel horsepower gains on the N54 with downpipes. So if you go with the high flow catted downpipe, you'll probably see gains slightly on the lower end of that ballpark, whereas Catless downpipes will likely provide gains closer to the higher end, closer to that 20 to 25 wheel horsepower mark. So not a huge difference, and certainly a lot more convenient when it comes to emissions testing and inspections. One final note on downpipes for the N54. When it comes to sounds, downpipes are really fairly modest. Even if you go with Catless downpipes, it's going to sound a little bit louder and a little bit more aggressive on a cold start. However, once the engine warms up and you're just sitting there idling or driving around town, driving on the highway, any kind of normal driving situations, you're really not even going to notice that the downpipes are modified in any way. However, when you dig into the throttle, then you will notice a slightly more aggressive exhaust note as well as a little bit more turbo spool. So kind of the best of both worlds in the sense that really not noticeable at all for standard normal driving. However, when you do want to get on the throttle and use the power, you do get that slightly deeper, more aggressive exhaust note and some turbo sounds. One final note on that, with the Catless downpipes standing outside of the vehicle, you probably will notice a little bit more of a raw fuel smell since there aren't any catalytic converters in there, but it's really not that noticeable and not something that most people would notice or be too concerned about. Moving on to upgrade number 4 for the best BMW N54 performance upgrades, we have an upgraded FMIC or front mount intercooler. The N54 factory intercooler, even on totally stock applications, still not very efficient. However, at 8 or 9 PSI, the stock boost levels, the factory intercooler is fine. It's fairly sufficient. When you start turning boost up, though, of course, the turbos are going to generate more heat, and the factory intercooler quickly becomes overwhelmed. So that's where upgrading to a larger intercooler, something with a bigger core and a larger surface area, is really going to help keep those intake air temperatures in check and help maximize performance. Now, the single biggest benefit of an FMIC or front mount intercooler upgrade is really just going to be the consistent performance. If you own an N54 and don't have an upgraded intercooler, you've probably noticed, say you fire up the car, get it warmed up to operating temperature, and you do a couple pulls, everything feels great. However, after that, the next time you get on the throttle, it really just feels dead and kind of lackluster. And that's because those intake air temperatures are getting too hot. The car's starting to pull a little bit of boost, a little bit of ignition timing, since those IATs are getting hotter, and increasing the chance of engine knock and detonation. And so really, that's the name of the game with upgraded intercoolers. It's going to help keep those intake air temperatures down, which ultimately results in that very consistent performance versus a stock intercooler. After a couple pulls, you can start losing 10, 15, even 20 plus wheel horsepower as those intake air temperatures start climbing and getting too hot. Ultimately, intercooler upgrade is an excellent addition to the N54, especially once you start modifying the vehicle and pushing upwards of 15 plus PSI. An intercooler is going to offer excellent benefits on the N54. One final thing to mention on front mount intercoolers is sizing. So if you're on stock turbos and planning to stick with stock turbos for the foreseeable future, a smaller, like 5-inch intercooler will suffice. That'll actually probably be the better option, since as you move into larger and larger intercoolers, you actually start to see more of a pressure drop as that air moves from the turbos into the intercooler. It'll start expanding just since you have such a much larger core, and it can also increase turbo lag. So really, if you're on stock turbos and plan to keep it that way for the foreseeable future, I'd recommend sticking with the smaller 5-inch intercooler. It'll be plenty efficient and plenty effective on stock turbos and help maximize power gains by reducing the pressure drop and turbo lag. The alternative is looking at larger 7 or 7.5-inch intercoolers. That's something that we would strongly recommend, especially if you are looking to move into a single turbo or upgraded twins in the future. Then you'll eventually need that extra cooling capacity, so you might as well go ahead and jump in, do it right the first time, get that much larger, more efficient intercooler in the 7 or 7.5-inch size. Moving on to upgrade number 5 for the BMW N54, we have an E85 blend, and more specifically looking at a roughly E30 to E40 blend. Both the JB4 and MHD off-the-shelf maps and stages offer roughly E30 to E40 tune, so it's as simple as switching over to that map or flashing over to that stage with MHD, mixing an E30 blend into the tank, and you can see power gains on an E30 blend of about 10 to 20 wheel horsepower, if not a bit more. Ultimately, E85 ethanol is cheaper at the pump than regular gasoline. It will reduce your fuel economy a little bit, but if you do have access to E85, this is essentially a free upgrade that can offer 10 to 25 wheel horsepower. And the way ethanol offers those power gains is it burns significantly cooler than gasoline, and it also has less energy density. And so what that means is you're actually injecting more fuel into the engine. It reduces the chance of any engine knocks and helps further cool the engine and the cylinder internal temperatures. So ultimately, E85 has tons of great benefits, incredible power gains, as well as really keeping the engine safe and healthy. So something we highly recommend if you do have access to E85. Now, the reason I was pointing out specifically the roughly E30 blend here is, again, not only are there off-the-shelf maps for that, but E30 to E40 is about where the stock low-pressure fuel pump is going to start maxing out, depending on the health of your factory fuel pump. Anything higher than that will likely start crashing the fuel pump, and it'll just be too much for it to handle. So you will need to look into low-pressure fuel pump upgrades if you do plan on running higher than an E30 or E40 blend. So just something to keep in mind. This is absolutely one of the best mods, and something that I would encourage that you try out if you are looking to mod your N54 and squeeze out that bit of extra power, while also keeping the engine much safer and healthier in the process. Last but not least, our last upgrade for the BMW N54 are turbo inlet and outlet upgrades. So turbo inlets and outlets, when combined, can show power and torque gains of about 30 to 50 wheel horsepower and roughly 40 to 70 wheel torque. Incredible power and performance gains. However, really the only way you're going to see numbers this impressive is really by pushing the absolute limits of the stock turbos at 19 to 21 plus PSI. This is something that's mostly recommended for those who are, again, trying to max out the stock turbos, build the most powerful stock turbo N54 possible, and really push upwards of that 475 to 500 wheel horsepower ballpark. However, the one thing to note here is once you do start pushing into that territory, it's really pushing the upper limits of the stock turbos. They're already not the most reliable stock turbochargers around. And so once you move into inlets and outlets, if you really are looking to push the limits, which again is really the only case that I would recommend them and that I think they're worthwhile, be ready for the possibility that you will blow the stock turbos sooner than later. And so this is kind of one of those final stage mods I would recommend if you are planning on moving to a single turbo, then just go ahead and skip the inlets and outlets since those won't be used when converting to a single turbo. So really, I'd mostly recommend inlets and outlets for those of you who are in the final stages, almost ready to move to upgraded twin turbos, but just aren't quite ready for that commitment and investment yet. Just keep in mind that inlets and outlets are going to show those power gains when pushing the limits. And when pushing the limits, it's likely that you will run into stock turbo failure sooner rather than later. Ultimately, guys, that sums up the 6 best bolt-on performance upgrades for the BMW N54. All of these mods combined can push the N54 upwards of 475 to 500 wheel horsepower and about 500 to 530 wheel torque. So incredible numbers for a stock turbo car. But if you do really try to push the stock turbos to those power levels, chances are they're not going to last that long. It's impossible to put a specific number on it. The turbos might hold up for a couple years, or they might only hold up for 10 or 20 or 50 pulls, whatever the number is. I know in my case, once I did inlets and outlets, I blew the stock turbos pretty quickly thereafter, which ultimately I was planning on moving to upgraded twins at some point. It wasn't a big deal. And that was a big reason I did the inlets and outlets, is I knew that I would need or want those upgrades when I did the turbos anyway. So I just decided until I was ready to do upgraded turbos, I'd have some fun, try pushing things to the absolute limit. But just really wanted to point out that if you are looking to maximize the N54 stock turbos, they're not the most reliable things in the first place, and pushing them to the limits could drastically reduce their lifespan. But nonetheless, that's really all it takes to push the N54 to 450 plus wheel horsepower. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content. Thanks, guys.